Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Can you stand on your feet? Come on, can you stand on your feet with us tonight? We just want to usher God's presence in tonight. Could you put your hands together? Come on.
Worship and adore you. My love song,
my love song,
love song. marriage ceremony of Reverend Franklin Smith Cook and Kimberly Montel Gresham. We welcome you as we gather here on their invitation to celebrate this momentous occasion and to share in their joy. Marriage is a holy and divine institution rightly sanctioned by God. It is one of the most important decisions these persons will make in this life. It is a covenant between these persons that they will commit themselves to each other, seeking God's guidance and approval in engaging in this lifelong endeavor. The scriptures say to us, the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. For this reason, the man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. Scripture challenges each of you, both individually and together, to understand, first to the groom, that husbands ought to love your wives, just as Christ loved the church, gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. To the bride, the scripture says, wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For if the husband is the head of the wife, Christ is the head of the church, his body of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their own husbands in everything. And to both of you, the scripture says, submit yourselves one to another out of fear and reverence for the Lord Christ. For love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes. It always perseveres. These are the challenges by the word of God and the scriptures that bind this holy matrimony. They've come today on this beautiful May day, as spring seems to be finally in the air. You waited longer for this day than we waited for spring to come. But it does come. Each season of life, no matter how long the wait, it comes. And in its season, it brings it forth its fruit. The fruit that comes today, in this season of preparation, comes because you've taken serious the issue of premarital counsel, the ability to learn not only God's word, but study one another. Because this serious undertaking should not be taken lightly nor entered without godly counsel, constructive advice, and earnest prayer. So by the standards of myself and this church, we have sufficiently completed premarital counsel and are willing to be joining on this day in holy matrimony. If any person has just cause why this couple should not be joined, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. Let us pray. O God, we invoke thy presence now upon this gathering and upon this couple. Let their commitment this day, O God, be grounded and based in your will and upon your word. I pray, O God, that they would have a solid foundation of what wish to build as they build upon those things that matter most. I pray that you would be with them in the difficult days that lie ahead and multiply their joy as they grow together now as one in this season of their life. Give them the fruit that comes from having waited for the right time and the right purpose. Teach them the importance of constant communication with you and with each other, as together they now journey through life, together as one. May they forever be blessed by your presence and with your grace as we commend them to your divine care. I pray it in the name of the Father. I pray in the name of the Son. I pray in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Who gives this woman to be wed?
We do.
Thank you, and you may be seated. We enter now into this time where the sharing of the sacred vows are given. I would that you would repeat after me. Reverend Cook, do you, Franklin Cook, take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, and do you promise before God and these witnesses to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto her, as long as you both shall live, or so say I do.
I do.
I believe he does. Do you, Kimberly, take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto him, so long as he both shall live? If so, respond by saying, I do.
I do.
She does as well. Praise the Lord. The rings, please. The rings I have been given are round and circular, having no noticeable beginning or ending. They symbolize the love that God has for us and the love that seals this marriage. I bless them now in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Place and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I share with thee.
I share with thee.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
With this ring,
with this ring,
I be wed,
I be wed,
and with all my worldly goods,
all my worldly goods,
I share with thee,
I share with thee,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. It is now my tradition to ask you, this congregation, this body of relatives, friends, and well wishers, that you also agree today to make a covenant. And your covenant is to not to interfere with decisions that this couple must now make for themselves, but to continue to love them and support them in whatever decisions they make, giving counsel only when asked, and in the best interest of both parties to this marriage. If so, respond, we will.
We will.
Amen. And this service is recorded. It is my tradition in the marriage ceremony to share both cultural and spiritual communion. Cultural communion comes to us out of the tradition of the African tribe. The tribal culture of Africa, of many of the traditions, has something called the sharing of the fruit. In the sharing of the fruit, it symbolizes a very important aspect of marriage. It suggests that you are now responsible for feeding each other, both physically, emotionally, mentally, socially, and spiritually. It means Franklin Cook learning to laugh when Kimberly laughs. It means Kimberly learning to cry when Franklin cries, in case he cries. It means being able to feel one another's pain and each other's joys. It means making sure that you don't just look out for yourself, but you're now responsible to look out one for the other. The fruit also makes a substance called mortar. Mortar is what bricks are held together by. And understand that this bond of marriage that you share today represents that there's something that holds you, even no matter how hardened you become. There's something in between that holds you. The love of each other and the love of God is the sealing mortar of this marriage. And your ability to feed one another will help you hold you even in the difficult times. So symbolizing this wonderful tradition of the sharing of the fruit, Brother Cook, choose a piece of fruit that you know your bride would like and feed your bride. Who wants to see you eat the whole thing? Now, Kimberly, you also have the privilege of choosing a piece of fruit that you believe your husband would like and feed your husband. Amen. As you now enjoy the eating of the fruit, remember you did not feed yourself, but you were fed by the other. And so it is. The life that you now walk together as one. Enjoy the journey feeding each other. And now, the spiritual communion is celebrated as we deal with what we call the Christian church sharing of the cup. Jesus shed his blood that we celebrated not long ago on Easter. The shedding of the blood represents the forgiveness of sin. He said, when I see the blood, I will remember their sin and iniquity no more. He died that we might have a chance to be able to be forgiven. Without his blood, our sins would come before the Almighty. But because of the shedding of the blood and because of the covering of the blood, we are forgiven. Sharing of the cup today symbolizes a simple truth, and that is, if Christ could forgive you individually of your many sins, surely you must learn how to forgive one another of whatever comes between you. So the most important words you can say to one another, other than I love you, is I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I didn't mean to hurt you. Can we try this again? The words of forgiveness. He said on the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. There would be days that you do know what you do, but you still must learn the power of love and the power of forgiveness. This wedding is also made complete by the sharing of the cup, and as you share the cup one with the other, remember, it symbolizes your willingness to forgive.
Kimberly? Lagerman. Having shared communion one with the other, symbolizing the love of Jesus Christ and the bond that happens with us as a result of being one with God, in light of this communion, today, the celebration of the communion experience suggests the two become one. Amen.
Amen.
Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit, give me the words that will bring me life. Words on the wings of the morning that dark night will fade away. Sweet to my heart, sweet to my heart, Holy Spirit, message of love to encourage me. Lifting my heart, don't despair, how you love me and help me. Sweet to my heart, sweet to my heart, Lord, give me your holy word that I can't hear from you. When I know what to do, I won't.
If I can't hear from you,
Kimberly, you're a beautiful bride. I suppose you might have died. But remember your real beauty, determined not by your external, but your internal capacity to love the Lord. To remember to keep His statutes. And to love one another as He has loved you. And as much as you, Franklin, and you, Kimberly, have thus consented in holy matrimony, and have witnessed the same before God of these friends, having pledged your faith in and love to each other, and having sealed the solemn marital vow by giving and receiving the rings, acting in the authority vested in me by the laws of this state, and looking to heaven for divine sanction, I now pronounce you husband and wife. But therefore God has joined together, let not man put aside. Now in a moment, Franklin, you long been waiting. You may salute your bride. Yeah.
Amen. Henceforth, you travel life's road together. Let love guide all your relationships. May Christ be the head of your home, the unseen guest at every meal, the silent listener to every conversation. May heaven's constant benediction crown your union with increasing joy and blessedness, and unite your hearts and lives by the grace and true affection of a happy marriage. May the Lord bless and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you. May the Lord grant you his shalom, his peace. May the Lord guide your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. And the church said, amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I present to you Reverend and Mrs. Franklin and Kimberly.
Him glory.
For the gift God gave to you.
This Looking good.
Looking, it looks good on you.
I say your gift.
It looks good.
Yeah.
Looking, it looks good on you.
Work your grace.
It looks good on you.
My gift works for me.
Looking, it looks good.
Yeah.
And you wear it well.
And you're wearing your gift well.
God has graced you. And you wear it.
All right, Toby,
well.
Help me out. You wear it. Works for you.
It looks good.
Tell somebody, just be you.
Again, it looks good on you.
Uh-huh.
It looks good on you.
Can't be a better again, you than
it
you.
Looks good.
And you wear.
And you wear it well.
God has graced you.
God has graced yeah. you. And
come
you
on, let's
wear
take it up.
Everywhere.
Alto.
It looks good on you.
Yeah.
It looks good on you.
Y'all wearing alto
again,
wear.
It looks good on you.
Say it again. Yeah.
It looks good.
Good attitude.
It looks good on you.
And you wear it.
And you wear it.
Come on, let's encourage somebody to be themselves.
God has graced
you. God has graced you to be you.
And you
it's an honor.
Well.
Take it out. Soprano.
It looks good on you.
Yeah.
It looks good on you.
That's right, soprano.
Again, it looks good on you.
I see you.
It looks good.
Y'all wearing soprano well.
Again, it looks good on you.
You're graced in that area.
It looks good on you.
Work your grace.
Again, it looks good.
Somebody say, operate in your grace.
Hey!
If you operate in your grace, it'll make you prosperous.
God has graced
grace you to be you.
You
honor it.
Well.
Take it up. Tenors, you got it.
It looks good on you.
Come on, tenors.
It looks good.
Wear your grace.
It looks good on you.
Work your grace.
The gift, it looks good.
That's it.
It looks good on you.
Where you at?
The gift, it looks good.
And you wear it.
And you wear it well.
God has graced us all.
God has graced
with the
you.
Gift. Now wear it well.
And you wear it well.
This is it.
The gift, it looks good. The gift, it looks good on you.
You are born with a grace.
The gift, it looks good on you.
That grace is your gift. Yeah.
The gift, it looks good on you.
It's a divine enablement.
The gift, it looks good on you.
If you work your grace, the grace will work for you. Company, teach the lesson.
The systems of the world
system.
Will try to take your confidence.
Yes, they will.
For these systems were designed.
Designed.
To make you doubt what heaven said.
Don't you doubt.
The systems of the world.
These systems.
Will try to take your confidence.
Yes, they will.
For these systems were designed.
Designed.
To make you sit down.
Don't you let
me. But the gift God gave to you.
This gift.
Give it back to him.
Offer it up.
When he sees it operating.
Yes.
It's a compliment to him.
Gives him glory.
But the gift God gave to you.
This gift.
Give it back to him.
Offer it up.
For the gift it will make room.
Uh-huh.
Position for great men to see you. The gift it looks good on you.
Your gift.
It looks good on you.
Looking good.
The gift it looks good on you.
I say your gift.
It looks good.
Yeah.
The gift, it looks good on you.
Work your grace.
It looks good on you.
My gift works for me.
The gift, it looks good.
Yeah.
And you wear it
and
well.
And you're wearing your gift well.
God has graced you. And you wear it well.
All right, Toby, help me out. You wear it.
You wear it well. You wear it well.
God has graced you.
God has graced you.
Gift works for you.
It looks good.
Tell somebody, just be you.
The gift, it looks good on you.
Uh-huh.
It looks good on you.
Can't be a better you than you.
The gift, it looks good.
And you wear.
And you wear it well.
God has graced you.
God has graced you.
Come on, let's take it up.
It well.
Say it again. Yeah.
It looks good.
With attitude.
The gift, it looks good on you. It looks good on you.
Looks good.
The gift, it looks good.
And you wear it.
And you wear it.
Come on, let's encourage somebody to be themselves.
God has graced you
to be you. It's an honor. I see you.
It looks good.
Y'all wearing soprano wear.
The gift, it looks good on you.
You're graced in that area.
It looks good on you.
Work your grace.
The gift, it looks good. And you wear it well.
God has graced you to sing soprano.
God has graced you.
Come on.
And you
take
wear
it out.
It well.
That's your grace. Bam. Come on, everybody. Put your hands up. Look at somebody say, operate in your grace.
Save in this place.